Hello, collective. Hello, collective. I hope y'all having a wonderful day today. I appreciate each and every one of you all. And I thank you very, very much for clicking on my channel. I hope I can just make some of y'all smile out here today on your path. And maybe this will resonate with a few of you out here. And if you're 47, it may resonate because that's the numbers I pulled out was 47, or you could be 74, I guess, but that could have been when you was born, but let's get into it. First card it pulled out was owls. Do you love my new card I made for the collective? It said, owls are an embodied spirit of the dead or associated with a spirit in some way. You know, this is about using your wisdom to teach others about the things that you know of, and using your intuition and your wisdom to warn others. It's about supernatural powers. You're an independent thinker. You are very observant when you're listening to others. So someone is sitting and observing you. They're listening to what you're saying. And I think that if you have a past or a loved one, they might be trying to connect to us in this message right here. And what came out was penguins. And penguins symbolize loyalty, devotion, unity, parental love, elegance, sociability, and adaptability. So whoever this person was that passed away, they were very loyal and devoted to you. This could be someone's parent out here trying to reach out to them. I mean, my parents are still alive, so this might be for somebody in the collective. Or it could be a child of yours. And, you know, I have had a child pass away, Alan. I got this from his funeral, and I believe that's why it pulled out right here, a star child. It's letting you know that your star child is somebody who knows what humility means, you know. And they're like a wolf spirit now. There, you know, this is about freedom from pride or arrogance. That's what this person has learned. You do not have a low opinion of yourself, you know, but you have an accurate opinion of yourself. That's what humility means, okay? And you put your accomplishments into perspective, you know. You acknowledging that you're smart, but you're not all-knowing or have power, but are not omnipotent either, but that's what humility means. And I think that maybe a passed over loved one wants to tell you that they appreciate you from letting go of all that arrogance that you had inside you at one time, and your pride, and you've adapted very well, and you're like a social little penguin right there, you know. You're practicing your elegance. And I think this is why the water come out. It's for the penguin, because the penguin needed some water. but this is about, becoming a clear channel for spirit. Communicating with the higher guidance from the spiritual, from the loving spiritual worlds. So at the moment you're receiving channel message, and it's trying to dislodge all these lower vibes and sensitize you to the subtle realms of light. And I got that from the Light Workers Oracle, the meaning of that. So you're receiving higher guidance from the spirit realm at the moment. This is your past or loved ones helping you, and they know that you're a medium and you connect with the spirit world, and you bring back information to people who's lost loved ones, like I do, you know. And remember, collective, when the mind is content, joy follows like a shadow that never leaves your side, okay? You've cried a lot about this person that passed away. That's why this woman's under an umbrella, you understand? But what it's saying to me, if you're worried about this person, if they're around you, don't be worried about it, because this spirit is connected to you some way all the time. They try to bring back information to you, like, you know, like me. And you could be 47, like I said, or you could have been born in 74. And I think this is funny because my husband has a sister that passed away in 74 and he's 47. So this might be for him that he needs to watch. It could be Alan connected with him. But the essence of four is all about security. It suggests solid foundations and perimeters that contain and protect. The determined and conservative four works hard to provide strong fences and square meals for nourishment. They're very practical, cautious, reliable, the salt of the earth. And then the essence of seven, this is about analysis. Seven goes within itself to contemplate its place in the universe. It begins to think and to analyze past experiences and present situations, and it wonders what lies ahead. Seven realizes the skills it's developed must be perfected in preparation for the future. Seven is physical rest and mental work. Noises and crowds disrupt your inner being. So, you know, somebody, they get upset if they're in a big crowd, but spirit's telling you you know, you need to be practical, and you still need to go out and socialize with people. This is what your star child in heaven wants you to know, or your star parent. You know, take it as it is. Somebody that passed away, this could be a friend of yours, a grandparent, a mother, a father, a child, definitely. And, you know, they're preparing you for the future, that you're going to have to be more adaptable and social if you're doing a spiritual something like me, you know, and that might be what somebody's needing to realize, you know. You know, just realize that you're a very hard worker. You're a great provider, and then elephants came out. It says elephants have a great memory. When one dies, the other elephants mourn their loss. This can last for days, but you know, with human beings, we let our pride and arrogance take over, and it might last for years and years before we let this person go. Do you understand? But all I know is your memories, what's in your memory and in your heart, this is things that will never go away. All I know is it's saying if this person is worried about if their child loved them, if you had a child that passed away, yes, they know that you showed parental love and that you was devoted, and they appreciate you for that. They're wanting you to know that, and they're wanting you to know that it was okay mourning them this long, but you need to find your peace and let it go. You know, find your happiness and then share it. You need to share your happiness, but it said you're guarding your baby, and spirit is protecting it good. This is your little egg. This might be, you know, if you're building a practice like me and you're protecting it real good, and it's saying your star child is protecting it real good for you. They can't wait till people get to see how good you are in your practice, and you start sharing it. They want you to know that collective now. But you got to have a lot of rest and do all this mental work on the inside, okay? But Ramses II pulled out, and you know, this was a monumental builder, one of Egypt's greatest pharaohs. He reigned for 67 years in the 13th century before Christ. Many scholars believe he was the pharaoh who gave Moses such a hard time regarding the Israelites' exodus from Egypt. He built many temples on the Nile River. So maybe, there's a scholar listening to me right now. Maybe you teach at a university or something, but you could be a great builder, and you're building something today. You might be building this with another child, and your star child in heaven wants you to know that they know that you're building with their brother at the moment, with your brother or sister. That you're all doing something together. They see whatever it is that you're all doing together. And you might need to set out a plate today for your passed over loved one, and leave it on your table and say, "There, my loved one in heaven, I love you, and I'm leaving you something to eat. Offer them up something to eat today." I think that's what they're wanting, okay? But somebody might be taken back all the information, like I'm saying, and they're taking it to their platform. Well, you're not going to prevail because I made all these cards by hand. So remember, when you do that, we're going to know exactly where you got the idea from Poundstar.org or Riot Collective. See, I'm not worried about it. I bring back information to my loved ones. I know these shadows, they never leave us. The shadows of the dead, they never leave us. They're always right there observing and listening and guiding us. So people can believe it or not, but I know. And I know that someone is a damn direct, clear channel for spirit, and you need to get next to water, and this will help you, okay? And your past or love will want you to get outside and have power in yourself and love yourself enough to adapt to these situations where you got to be social. You need to do that, okay? But I think you're all building. You're building something. You're protecting it really good, and you try to share your happiness with others, you know. And it's okay to mourn someone that we've lost. I want y'all to know that, okay? And if you're 47, you're passed over loved one, they said they love you, and you provided a great life for them, and they want you to know that you always fed them, and you was a very reliable father, and they want you to know that, or mother, if you have a passed over child. But and you just got to stop analyzing all these past situations and, you know, and wonder what lies ahead and realize the skills that you need in the moment. You got to let go of all that pride and arrogance, okay? That's what your star child is telling you today, Collective. That's for somebody. I love you, Collective. I hope it helps you. I hope it helps you a little bit. See if we can tower message. See what they want to say. What do they want to say today, Spirit? What's a tower message today for the collective? Oh, for the collective. Oh. Regaining or losing control. Mastery, choices, responsibility, secret. There's a secret coming out. There's a secret coming out. There's a secret coming out. That's Aquarius energy. Let's see what else. Secret. What's the secret, Spirit? Oh, there's a secret coming out in someone's spiritual connection, in their partnership. This is about unified love, partnership, mutual attraction, proposal. Y'all might be married or in a connection already. Oh, it could be some involving a work situation, you know, and that's third deacon in Capricorn and first deacon in Cancer. So maybe someone is acting strategically at the moment in this partnership. You're all learning and implementing and building something together. You're building something together, yes. And, you know, you're going to see the fruits of your labor here very soon. That's Virgo energy. This is about you being self-sufficient, having rewards. Oh, look, you're the Empress. Looky there. You're going to be a wealthy Mrs. Empress. You know, that's Venus energy. This is about abundance, nurturing, fertility, feminine, good parenting. So, I mean, hang on, what does this say upside down? Maybe you done come clean. I believe that's what this means. I believe that you all came clean to each other in your partnership, okay? You had to, it was lies, and you told these secrets. You kept secrets in your marriage, you know, and maybe you told your partner. I think you did, because it says you come clean, you know, and it's unified your love even stronger. Your partnership can't be broke. You all learn from each other all the time. You both was telling truths, you know, and you're going to receive the fruits of your labor very soon. You're very abundant. You're very abundant in giving, you know, and you're a good parent. You're a good parent. and it's okay. We all have secrets, and you know, you was feeling a little wounded, the wounded warrior. You know, because you had to speak of all the lies and betrayal. You know, you had to have courage and stand up, you know, and come clean with all this suffering that you was hanging on to, you know. That was your last stand, keeping that secret. It took a lot of strength and compassion to let those secrets out, because not everybody does that in a loving connection. They'll hang on to stuff till they die. Yeah, they will. I mean, I hope that you all have someone that, you know, that'll help you. Oh, and then we got Hermit. Yeah, you had to go inside and do some deep soul searching and introspection, and you started seeking the truth, you know. You've been alone, and you're very independent, and at this job, this could be an old job that you might have completed out of cycle. Maybe you quit that job because you had multiple priorities, and you always felt like you was juggling because you was being pulled in many different directions, you know, and you had to choose togetherness, you and your partner. And that's what you did, and you're going to have financial independence because you got on that path to financial freedom by yourself, you and your partner. You both did it, you know, and you're all having blind faith, and this is about you all having adventures, and you're going to be receiving an opportunity, and it's going to make you feel so happy. It's going to make you feel so happy. What under Empress? Do we have Emperor? Emperor? Holy wowdy, look. Wheel of Fortune. That's what it is. You know, you're getting ready to have good luck karma. You know what? We all had to go through these life cycles. It's about your destiny. This was about ups and downs in life, you know, and you figured out. Oh, and looky here, we got King of Pentacles. So it could be saying, I mean, I done said you, whoever's listening to me, listener, you know, you told your secrets and it wounded someone, and it could have been, you know, you could have been with a King of Pentacles, a Taurus, Virgo, or Capricorn. But it could be saying, you know, that you had the courage and you put boundaries up. You come clean to this Taurus, Virgo, or Capricorn. That's why you're going to receive prosperity, because the angels is proud that you unified your love. You both went inside and started seeking more wisdom, you know, and you're a natural leader. You're a natural leader. That's Scorpio and Sagittarius energy. Yeah, but you're a natural leader. You're working together. You don't have multiple priorities to juggle anymore, and that's why you're going to have, you're going to be celebrating together with this new job that you're doing, your creativeness. But you're going to have to remember that you're going to have this time management skills. You're going to have to manage your skills a little bit better so you can see the fruits of your labor in this new beginning. Oh, let's see, yep. You're working, you're building. You're doing your due diligence. You're doing this passionately. You have high standards. You're in apprenticeship. You're mastering your skill development at the moment. You're mastering your skill development at the moment. That's what it is. Oh, look what's coming. Oh, wow. The wheel is turning for good luck for you, Empress. You're going to have love and compassion, and you're getting all this creative energy flowing down from the divine. You have new feelings with this spiritual connection. You have new feelings with it. You used your intuition with your new baby. You was protecting your new baby. You might not even have a baby, but this is your baby. You're protecting your new baby. Yeah, you're going to receive some messages. Speed. Maybe these new feelings are going to pick up. Somebody's going to come towards you fast, collective. You know, I'm already with my partner. I don't know But something is manifesting quickly for you. Something's manifesting quickly for you. And what it is justice. Justice. Justice and fairness. Clarity, equality, balance. Natural law. So some karmic law has to get dealt out. See, because this emperor... Because you and the emperor are one. See, you and the emperor are... The justice is you and the emperor has a happy family. That was the karmic justice. They thought they could get you out of your happy, but they can't. And there's two fours together, so you might be seeing 44 a lot. Yeah, you might be seeing 44 a lot, or 22 a lot, or 99 a lot. And is there anything else? You might be seeing 333 a lot. You could have been born in 1980 or 1981. You might be 38 or 32 or 30. I don't know. I lost my train of thought. That's all I see. Sorry, collective. I know it's more to see, but 11 come out, so maybe 11-11. Let's see some of my messages, collective. Well, wait a minute. Let's see what it says with these. Hang on a second, collective. What's something that we need to know today about this unified love? Distance. Maybe you all been in separation, collective. You've been separated. But we're never separated during space. You know what else? This distance and these barriers help gain clarity for you. This is about setting your intentions and telling the truth, okay? This is about material world, money, career, status, third dimension. You're making your mark. You're making your mark in the material world, so don't doubt it. Because you're honest. You tell the truth, and people appreciate you for that, collective. Oh, your divine masculine, your twin, or soulmate is seeking you in my collective. Masculine seeking you. They're seeking you right now. Empress. Masculine seeking you, Empress. They've been conflicted. This masculine had many choices and they had to make a decision. Or you did, Empress. You did. Maybe this masculine was inconsistent with you. Yeah, because he had influence over him. A third party, a dark attachment, see? And they was trying to control your truths. They're trying to control your truths, collective, but they've been hoping, they've been waiting, they've been expecting you now, collective. They just, or maybe you've been hoping to make your mark in the world, okay? But you had to stop letting these dark attachments try to control your situation, okay? These people in the background, you gotta let go of your ego, masculine. You know, you gotta let go of that pride and jealousy. It's self-preservation. It's putting up your walls. Putting up your walls. When you're jealous, you're putting up your walls. And you need to admit that you might have had a multiple choice. You know, whoever is partner, you gotta let go of that karmic partner. That conventional relationship. Duty bound by societal conventions. So... somebody's been waiting and manifesting jealousy to come into your all's relationship because they think, like people think that my partner, me and my partner, that's my karmic, but they're not. So I don't know who this is, but mystery, they place magic on you. They place dark attachments on you. They're trying to control. The truth is, they're trying to control you to stay with your kids, whoever this is for. They're in resentment. They've been waiting and expecting money, but they're angry. They're angry over what you said to them. And your twin and soulmate, they're seeking you, but they can't let go of their jealousy. They got to change their perception. They're living in a delusion. They can't see through their own false beliefs. But they're conflicted. They got to make a decision, and they have to understand that this is a conventional relationship, and it's all about unconditional love, innocence, support from your whole heart. I don't know, but you're entering unknown territory. There's a lot of opinions and anger floating around your own beliefs at the moment. But you do have support because you always have your whole heart in this line. This third party is in stagnation. They're expecting that you're going to let your guard down and stop being bound by this societal contract. And up here, this separation in space and time brought out the truths about the third dimensions and making your mark with this twin or your soulmate that has that's been inconsistent. Okay, I don't know if that made sense. I'm gonna get my cards, okay? But me and you, we're about dedication, trust, and reliability. We're loyal. We're loyal. We're loyal. This is us. I love you, spirit. This is me. We're loyal. We're dedicated. We're feminines. We speak the truth. We've got an established family we're going to triumph in. And spirit protects us and gives us signs. I love you, spirit. Spirit gives us signs and reminders about this elusive person that ghosted you. Look, it looks like a ghost. Yeah, well, that's a tricky, dishonest person. And you learned that was a dark attachment and you didn't want nothing to do with it. Good collective. Good collective. I love you. I'm glad you did that, okay? I'm glad you did that now, collective. Hang on. I'm taking a little from here and a little from there. And a little from here and a little from there. And then we're going to see what it says, baby. Now let's see what these say. Spirit said, here's what it is, baby. Here's what it is, baby, baby. See what my message is said for my collective spirit. I love you and I thank you. Me and my collective needs to know a message. Whoa, whoa, whoa. Somebody's trying to thumbs down our videos. Or your videos, collective, if you all do things. There's karma is coming back to these people, though. It tried to come up against a chosen one here on Earth. Their thumbs down in your videos. They don't like that you have a man. That's the difference in you and this person. They don't like you, and they're booing you. And this person, they can't manifest anymore because they was hiding that they was doing this to you, to a chosen one. Poof, poof. Whatever they wish, they can't do it anymore. They can't make their magic work anymore. Because these people, all they can do is point fingers and never take accountability. Well, that's not me. I took accountability in my life, and anybody says I didn't, get off my fucking channel. Because karma's going to come bite you in the ass. I know that you need to clean up some shit in your life, whoever you are. It ain't me. I have been doing that. But whoever this person is, they're purely disrespective. And this person is neglecting your feelings. And they might be trying to deplete you of energy. And you don't know if you can trust this person. Or if they even really care about you. It's somebody that's don't like your videos. They come up against you. And it could be somebody that might have sexually abused you, collective, when you was young. They're going around telling people that you're a liar. And they're booing what you do. But karma's coming up against this person. And people isn't always going to agree with us. But we have to accept people's differences. See, I know this. I know people isn't going to agree with everything I do, but it doesn't matter. I mean, that's them. They have their belief, and I have mine. But when you just be yourself and show the real you, that's when the one that's meant for you will see your true beauty and divinity shining through, and they'll come to you. See? See? And this person that's been booing you and mad because you're all different, and they wish they would have not said these things about whatever they went lying about, they just went around saying, they just point fingers at you. Well, they wish they hadn't did that, because they know that you're true and you're shining through, you and your partner, and you have this, and they wish they hadn't said things about you. And this person, they think you're weird simply because you're a joy to be around, and you like to make people laugh, and you do things differently. You can't fit a square peg in a round hole. People, you just can't do it. Karma's going to bite that person in the ass. Don't worry. And this purely disrespected person, they're wanting to give you a mushroom. Imagine what that means. You know, they're wanting to give you a mushroom. And that might be this person that sexually abused you. Well, they're sick. Oh, and this person, they've been dealing with a warlock. Oh, and it could be a woman that talks about warlocks on her channel all the time. And she might even have a magical wand laying on her table, and you all never noticed it. But she's mad because you're different, that you and your partner work together, and she's been needing a real man in her life. Well, stop holding resentment towards people that does have that, you know, and stop dealing with these people so you can realize your life purpose, you know. But karma's coming back to these people that didn't accept you for who you was, and it could be somebody that you worked with, a partner, a boss, or a friend that didn't accept your y'all's differences. They went around lying and hiding what they did. Now they wish they would have told you, because shit's getting ready to hit the fan because they stole a bunch of your money or something, from your family's money. Yeah, they're trying to do that. And you and your partner, you're all having a celebration. You all just love each other. But the karma's coming back and hitting this person right in the eyes. Their story's getting ready to change. They changed their story. This person that sexually abused you, they've changed their story 15 times. And now people's realizing that they're not a real true person. And this person, they've been trying to put magic on you with you and your twin. But, you know, twins, it's all about divine timing. Nobody can stop what the divine had planned, okay? Nobody can stop what the divine had planned. Hang on, let me pull up my britches. I'm burning up. Yeah, but somebody's friend wants to celebrate with you. They feel like they're... You and them have the same life purpose. I don't know who this is for, collected, but it's for one of you all. But they know that they can feel the story's changing, and it's getting ready to turn into their favor. Okay, can we have another story on the top? Oh, North Node is South Node. So this person that is thumbs down in your videos just because you're different, they're living in their South Node. They're getting ready to receive their karma for trying to come up against you, because they paid a tarot reader to do magic on you. See, they paid a tarot reader to do magic on you on a chosen one, and they can't manifest anymore. And this card, that they've been trying to put your body and soul out of whack and out of balance. They was trying to disconnect you, but their magic doesn't work. This tarot reader's magic ain't worth a shit. And they might have hooked to your internet, and like how they did mine. And it's all funny. They thought they'd play around with me and slap me around a little bit and not let my work get around. But the Lord is getting ready to take them out. God is, okay? And, this person that needs to take accountability for what they done to you in your life, you make them feel like a kid. You make this first person feel like a kid, like a little puppy or a kitty playing. They feel playful with you. They like playing with you. But whoever is this man or woman is, they have a heart of stone. And you could pour out your love to this person, but they can't never open up like you do. Because that's why you're wondering if they even really care. Because they're feeling conflicted. Because they have a choice to make. For that story up there. Okay, what about dude that sexually abused you as a child is going around lying? He's a narcissistic rager. I love God. Y'all believe God yet? How much it's funny how it shows us? He's raging and mad because people isn't agreeing with him. Because they're not agreeing with him. That's funny. And your animals is trying to make you be aware of a spirit or a ghost in your house. So this rager is trying to send a ghost into your house. And your animals might be noticing it. And they might be barking and meowing a lot or something. You know that they see it. Well, they've sent a spirit over there. It's cold-hearted dickhead. Cold-hearted dickhead. Narcissist rager. Ain't that funny? But they didn't know what true divinity was and spirit guides. Please go take care of that person. That's all we had to say. Oh, that's all I had to say. And you and your partner, because you're all shining and you're doing your dream life together, your all's finances is getting ready to increase tremendously. And it's pissing off these people. It's pissing off these people because you're such a joy to be around, you know. And we know with that person, we don't worry about them in our mind. We're like, no way, get out of our mind. We're healed. We don't want you in our mind anymore. You're a karmic. You're a karmic in our life. And we cleared out that energy. It's not around us. It's not around us anymore. We got to sweep and clear that cold-hearted shit out of your house, okay? And, somebody's working with a witch or a warlock trying to get into a new relationship with you. Nah, no new relationships coming to me. So if y'all think so, you're dumb. They're trying to steal money from you and your partner. You know, this could be a boss or anybody stealing that money. But, you know, remember in life that challenges and tests will always arise. And know that the devil will try to tempt you away from your purpose. They're trying to... Somebody might be trying to tempt you with money now. Somebody might be trying to tempt you with money. They might be placing judgment on you and your family and all the tests you went through. But it's all right. The devil is getting these people that is in your family that's narcissist ragers that might have hurt you as a kid. And you're going to be celebrating because all this anger and bitterness is going to be shed away from you. And the government knows this, and the government is watching this take place. Are you listening? And red flag, story's changing. Plot twist, a good person will let you have something that you're in need of and not ask for anything in return. That's what good people do. I'm like, yes, I'm like that good person. See? We don't ask for nothing from you all because we're true twins, and we have unconditional... Look, we have ever-flowing, unconditional love. We put it in God's hands the way these people had did us in our life, me and my partner. And that's why we're this. That's why we're that. And I love you, Spirit. There's nothing karmic about me and my old man. We get ready to have a bunch. And somebody that loves to watch her toss around football, So somebody might be watching football today, your divine masculine, divine feminine, and they are thinking about how much they love you and your creative ideas. They have a lot of new feelings, and they support you wholeheartedly. Did you hear that? Oh, Spirit, you're so funny. You're so, so funny. Because you're a natural and unique, beautiful woman all on your own, and they see your beauty, and they know it. They know you're living in your north node. They know that karma's coming back to this tarot reader. They know it. And that's why they're feeling guilty and their headaches hurting. Because they doubted you. They doubted that you was balanced. They was trying to make you out of balance. And they was trying to plan something sneaky. Because they was planning something sneaky behind your back to leave you high and dry. That's why they're feeling like puppy play and kitty play at the moment. But everything's crumbling down, and they'll wish they had you to vent to, these people that thought they could play with you and smack you around like a little kitty kitty. And it's disrespectful, man or woman. They're getting ready to see how shitty that they done you, this narcissistic rager. He's going around lying to people, and he might have lied to a lesbian tarot reader and told her that you was gay, and now they're all mad because they know that you're not. Oh, and these dark spiritualists in the tarot community are sending out dark spirits to latch onto your animals to make you out of balance. They're wanting people to not agree with you or to watch your channel. Are you listening? That's what they're doing, collective. And that's crazy. I don't know who they are, but it's somebody that's in a... It's a lesbian tarot reader. And I'm not against anybody, but it's some lesbian tarot reader. And your finance is going to increase tremendously for showing the real you and telling things that's happened to you. With these people, you're manifesting money into your life. And whoever this blonde woman that had something to do with all the lies and setups, and God showed you and your spirit guides told you to get away from this person. See, they don't think you should be in the tarot community, even though they don't realize that somebody tried to set you up to murder you, attack you, or word you. No. They're like, no way, they didn't do that. Yeah, they did, so get off of my channel, you stupid woman, because you're actually a narcissist rager. And you take money from these narcissistic people, and that's not me. I've not used a damn dime. There's a woman giving me money on here, and I've kept it. I've still got $150 on my card, and I've got it in there, and I ain't used a dime off of it, so I don't know who that is, but this woman got paid a lot of money, and spirit guides did warn me about these people, and they think you're different, and like me, I'm in a partnership, and I'm happy. They're like, no way, you can't work your way up in this tarot business. You want to bet? I bet you fuck them money. I'll show you, baby, because I do know how to clean energy. And somebody is, what did that say underneath that? Oh, yeah, his karmic partner. This karmic partner that they want to show you the real person. Well, all they really was doing was lying on your name because you didn't sleep with them in the bed. So clean out that energy and don't want that son of a bitch back. And I don't. I cleared out energy like that. Yeah, that's not my husband. I don't know who that is, honey, but that's for one of you alls. But these people that's dealing with witches and warlocks, and they're trying to get you to be in a new relationship with them, they're great puppet master narcissists. Nah, we don't need that. We don't need a puppet master. We know that tests and challenges always arise. And these people that stole money from my family, if they tried to, they shouldn't be tempted. They can't tempt me away from my purpose. Something's going to happen in a split second to these people. And it's the government. The government is going to come tell you how they appreciate you for telling how these people spied and gawked and try to have you killed. You're going to have a celebration, and these people, they're going to be feeling resentment, and they might be placed behind bars. See that barbed wire fence? They're going to be fenced in, somebody that was in your community that was against you and your family. I love that funny. That's so funny. Celebration. Yeah, and Archangel Raphael came out, and he was a patron saint of healing the sick and ill people, as well as an angel for all healthcare workers. He works to heal people's minds, spirits, and bodies so they can be peaceful. See, the government knows that you have this in you, and they love you. And they know you're a good person, and they know that your story changed because you saw the red flags. And you've already developed your skills, and you're a good person, so don't doubt it. And you're getting the green light to move forwards and just go get what you want, collective. Just go get what you want, babies. Because somebody good's going to help you. Don't think they're not, okay? And maybe you're clairaudient, and this sometimes the gift of clear hearing. 4444. Oh, wow. You might be hearing people say whole sentences of thoughts, or you could be hearing thoughts of those in the spirit world and bells ringing or buzzing. And sometimes it will tell you to leave and it saves you from accidents. Or you can even hear your children. And I have. I've heard all this. And whoever stupid ass tarot reader at somebody's stupid narcissist, brother, boyfriend, husband, boss, partner, friend, whoever they paid to do this energy work on you, they paid a lesbian tarot reader, and they're stupid because they think that you're not happy and you have money. You're getting ready to have a big bag of money because this blonde woman might have been the one paid them to do all that dark energy. And you heard this person. You clearly heard it. This woman loves to watch football, her and her family. And it was all in divine timing to bring about this unconditional, to bring about all this support into me and my person's life. You're getting ready to receive a lot of love from the divine. Yeah. You're getting a lot of love from your partner and this person. They're mad because they don't. Because they went around lying and shit. Well, I hope this helped y'all today, collective. It seemed like a pretty good reading. It was for somebody, but just remember, I do love y'all, and I do try to give you all a message. You know what? Let me see about. Let me give y'all one of these. What's a message for the collective soul? Your soul is preparing to reconnect. Trust in the process. So somebody needs to listen to me. Trust this process. I haven't lost faith in it. Oh, yin and yang. The yin-yang symbol, twin flames, contain an aspect of each other's character within themselves. Your all souls are the same. You're all attempting to reconnect here in the 3D here soon, okay? Be ready to receive what fate has planned for you. You got to be ready to receive it now. Oh, it's your dreams. You share your dreams together and encourage each other to make them a reality. So, somebody might be coming to you in your dreams. It's your true love. True love comes when you least expect it. And look, love on the bottom. Love conquers all. Your true love, your soul, yin-yang twin, they're going to give you a surprise. You got to be receptive to this. They planned a surprise for you. You're going to feel like it's a dream. And because they honor you. They honor you. Their heart beats faster every time they get around you. You're going to get ready to receive a big surprise, collective. It's coming to you. So don't doubt it. It's coming. 4747. Oh, and remember, 47 was at the first of this. And I love God. And, you know, that's 1111. Look, 1111 is your twin flame. And I love y'all. And that's what it meant. So 4711 in that justice, it was 1111. So this is your twin. And they love you. Don't doubt it. Don't doubt that you're all going to be celebrating and feeling joy and harmony. And I know that sometimes you might get frustrated and you're like, when is it going to happen? I don't know. I'm not the divine. You got to let go of that time. Let go of that timing because it's going to happen when you least expect it. When you let go of ever, when you just let go of all expectations, it'll come just like a thief in the night. That's what it does, collective. That's what it'll do. We have one of these. This is the tree of illumination, truth, revelations, understanding. They're going to tell you their truth, that they understand you and they love you. And the secret of Camelot, the authority of spirit. They're letting spirit take them over. Spirit is their authority. They're being guided by spirit. They got to tell you their truth now, and they might be doing it in the springtime. Spirit of spring, freedom, action, power. Yep. That's when they're going to come tell you this secret and their truth of how much you've taught them of spirit, and they love you, and you taught them freedom and to take action and movement, and they appreciate you, and I do too, and I love y'all. And please like, subscribe, and share my videos today. I greatly need the help, and I greatly appreciate each and every one of y'all. I'm trying to give a deck away at 500, so help me get up to 500. I love you guys. Peace.